हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू रेडियो फ्रीक्वेंसी क्लासेस। इन टुडेज़ लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस दी बेसिक्स ऑफ आरएफ एम्पलीफायर। सो बेसिकली देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ फॉर्मेट विच आई एम गोइंग टू कवर। वन, आई विल यूज़ ए बीजेटी विच इज़ डिनोटेड एज कलेक्टर बेस एंड एमिटर थ्री टर्मिनल। ओके, सो हियर आई विल टेक एनपीएन ट्रांजिस्टर एंड आई विल एक्सप्लेन दी basis of the RF amplifier design. So two things I will explain. The first one will be the biasing and another one will be the decoupling circuit. And the second I will take the MOSFET metal semiconductor field effect transistor. Okay, so here the terminal will be denoted as drain, gate and source. So using this also I will explain the biasing and decoupling circuit. And also I will discuss the complexity while designing the RF amplifiers. So as I told, if I'll use a BJT and I will try to design the amplifier, there are two types. One is called as a low noise amplifier and another one is called as a high power amplifier. So low noise amplifier is used at receiver terminal and high power amplifiers are basically used at the transmitting terminal. So when we are transmitting the signal using the antenna and the gain of the antenna is not sufficient, in that case we need a high power amplifier to maximize the gain so that we can transmit the signal at larger distance. So as you can see here in this picture, I have a BJT transistor, okay, bipolar junction transistor. Three terminals are collector, base and emitter. And in our circuit theory, where we are using the low frequency, already we know we have to design how to design the biasing circuit, DC biasing circuit, okay, and how to design the amplifier for different classes based on the desired output, like class A, class B, class AB, class C. So many classes are there that all classes depends upon the desired output. But here when we are going for the high frequency, as the topic says RF amplifier, okay, so when we are designing for the high frequency, these amplifiers, whether it is low noise amplifier or high power amplifier, we have to consider two effects, which is most important. The first one is, we should be able to stop the AC also, AC signal. And the second important thing is matching. So at high frequency, these two things we have to consider. Okay, we should able to stop the AC signal. It should not get coupled at the desired locations. And another one is the matching of the points. So as you can see, when we are going to transmit the, if we'll apply one signal here, we are using first a capacitor. So what it is going to do is, this capacitor will act as a decoupling circuit. So whatever AC signal goes from this input supply, it will get coupled to this transistor base terminal. And if any DC signal is trying to couple, this capacitor will stop that AC DC signal. Okay, so we know that this capacitor will offer a high resistance for lower frequencies. So when frequency is zero for DC signal, that will not get coupled through this terminal. So only AC will be allowed. And as I told, the important parameter is AC signal avoidance from the DC supply, because to operate this transistor, okay, we have to design a particular DC biasing circuit. So when we are applying the DC through this collector terminal or through the base terminal, we should use the inductance, okay, some inductor we have to use. That will depend at what frequency we are going to operate, okay, and for what frequency we are going to design this RF circuitry. That will determine the inductance value at this place also and at this place also. This is also a given name by the engineers, that is called as a radio frequency chokes. Okay, this is also called as RFC, this inductance, which is used at high frequency to stop the AC, because we are going to provide DC signal from here, DC biasing from the collector terminal also and from the base terminal also. So we are going to use the inductance. Okay, so this will be going to stop the एसी सिग्नल एंड ओनली डीसी विल गेट कपल टू द कलेक्टर टर्मिनल एंड ऑल्सो एट द बेस टर्मिनल. सेम वे वी आर यूजिंग हेयर एट द आउटपुट टर्मिनल वन आई हैव डिनोटेड इज सी नॉट. दिस इज ऑल्सो अ डी कपलिंग कैपेसिटर. सो वॉट एवर एम्पलीफाइड सिग्नल कम्स हियर इट विल गेट कपल टू द आउटपुट पोर्ट. ओके एंड वॉट एवर डी सी इज देयर इवन इफ स्मॉल डी सी कम्स दैट विल बी स्टॉप्ड बाई दिस सी नॉट कैपेसिटर. सो दिस सी नॉट एंड सी आई बोथ आर गोइंग टू स्टॉप द डी सी सिग्नल एंड दिस टू इंडक्टेंस आर गोइंग टू स्टॉप द ए सी सिग्नल. ओनली डी सी विल बी कपल्ड. नाउ अनदर टू थिंग इज द इनपुट मैचिंग एंड आउटपुट मैचिंग नेटवर्क. सो इट्स ए स्टैंडर्ड डिजाइन एज वी आर नोइंग दैट वेन वी आर हैविंग एन एंटीना एंड इट्स गेन इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल. ओके एक्सेप्टेबल लेवल ऑफ गेन देन वी हैव टू मैक्सिमाइज इट. सो फॉर एंटीना द डिजायर्ड इम्पिडेंस इज 50 ओम. सो हियर एट द इनपुट टर्मिनल ऑल्सो we should match this point and this point. So if you are looking from here, if you see some other resistance and from here if you are looking, we should see the 50 ohm. So this input matching network will match in such a way so that whatever signal we are transmitting from this port, it should get coupled to the base terminal. Nothing should get reflected back. Okay, so the at high frequencies those parameters are represented by the scattering parameters. In my even video lecture, I have already explained the scattering parameter. So you can watch it and try to understand what is scattering parameter. And if you are well aware of these scattering parameters, then easily you can understand what I am talking about here. So this is input matching network, which is used to match the source terminal from the base terminal. So whatever signal we are transmitting from here, it should directly get coupled to the base and there should not be any reflection. Okay, if you are not designing a proper input terminal, input matching network, then this there will be certain reflection and we cannot able to transmit all the signal from the source to the base terminal. The same way, when signal reaches to the collector terminal, now we are trying to transmit it to the output port. So we use a output matching network which will match the collector terminal resistance or impedance, we can say in general, to the output terminal here. That is also called as a mesh termination MT for 50 ohm. Here also mesh termination 50 ohm. So if you are using any software like ADS or some other active component design tool, then you can understand that we can use matching termination at the output port and at the input port, and using the Smith chart basics and methods we can design the input matching network and output matching network, and we can avoid the possible reflection and we can design proper RF amplifier depending upon the cases. The same way we can understand for the MESFET. In case of MESFET, in place of collector, base and emitter, we are having drain, gate and source. And same way we are having RFC chokes, radio frequency choke to stop AC signal. So only DC should get coupled to the gate terminal. Same way only DC should come to this drain terminal. And these two CI and C naught is used to stop the undesired DC signal by input supply and undesired signal which is not at all allowed at the output terminal. So we can stop DC here and we can stop DC here by using these two decoupling capacitors. So this is also same way as I explained for the BJT. Okay, so this was the basic understanding of the RF amplifier. In my next video, I will take one example of the transistor for which the S parameter is given. So as you know, this transistor can be converted into a two port network. One will be called as output port and this side will be called as an input port. So when two ports are there, we will have four element to define the characteristic of this two port network. So those four element will be given as S11, S12, S21 and S22. So at particular frequency for a given transistor, these four parameter will be defined. So if these four parameters will be defined, we can find out the matching network, okay, and we can use the Smith chart and we can design a proper matching network at the input terminal and at the output terminal. Okay, and DC biasing, designing of DC biasing is quite easy as circuit theory. Directly we can apply that one and we can design for a particular case, a particular class of the amplifier, and then we can design the matching network and we can complete a RF amplifier design. So kindly be tuned for my lectures. In my next video lecture, I will explain the input and output matching network design for an RF amplifier using one example. If you like the content, kindly subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.